Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
What have the coaches been telling you about the Alouettes coming in this week? Obviously, they have a lot of weapons and arguably the greatest quarterback to ever play this game.
Yeah. It's going to be a challenge. They said, you think last week was something. This is going to be something. You know, this is a good team. Obviously, the quarterback, everybody knows who he is. It's going to be a challenge. It's going to be fun.
Does it come with a big game mentality, knowing you're going up against guys like Jamal Richardson, S.J. Green as a secondary? Does that get you guys being like, all right, we got to be ready to go. We're pumped up for this.
Oh yeah, every week you got to be ready because, you know, there's good guys all over this league, but particularly these guys, because I heard about them the first week I got here. And you see, this is the first time we're playing them. But, so it's going to be fun. But we're getting good looks all week from guys like Carr and Jay Harp on the big receivers giving us that look. So it's going to help us out.
Matching up against Montreal's offense, what's going to be the most challenging part? Obviously, there's going to be a lot of difficult parts for your defense, but
Getting after Anthony Cavill, you know, that's where the engine starts, you know, and we got to be able to contain him, take away his weapons, you know, make them one-dimensional. They got Whitaker, and then, you know, you look at their core receivers, but, you know, he's the one that masterminds everything, and, you know, so we got our work cut out. You know, it's going to take a total defensive effort from the front guys, the medium guys, and the back end guys to be a very consistent, very sound football game for us. So, be successful.
If you get the start, because that's what we're being told, what would it mean for you to play against the Montreal Alouettes?
You know, first and foremost, you know, I want to go out there and get the win. Secondly, you know, it would mean a lot to me just to go out there. You know, that's the last team that I played for. I have friends on that team. You know, I have a relationship with coaches and players on that team. So just go out there and, you know, show what I could do and, you know, just play my best.
How many tips do you have for your teammates on defense with Anthony Calvillo after practicing against him so long?
Well, there's not too many things you could get hints off of with Anthony because, you know, he adapts every week. You know, he learns from his mistakes. So you just got to go out there, you got to confuse him, and, you know, hopefully we could get some pressure on defense and, you know, score on offense.
What does he do to keep playing as a 40-year-old? You watch him in the locker room.
I think he found the fountain of youth a couple of years back there. Well, he just takes care of his body. He goes about his business like a professional. You know, he does the right thing. He's in early. He's in his playbook. He eats healthy, takes care of his body. You know, with the things that have happened to him over the last couple of years, you know, he's been taking care of his body a little bit more now, a little bit even better now.
Anthony Calvillo's been in the league forever now, and he's, you know, 40 or whatever he is. How does he stay so successful at his age?
I mean, he knows the game. He's smart. It's nothing that anybody can throw at him that he haven't seen. And him knowing the game, he knows the ins and the outs of every route. He probably knows the wingspan of every DB he's going against, man. He's been in the game that long, and he knows where to put the ball, when to put it there, when you're blitzing, what alignment you're in. I mean, he's one of the greatest of all time. So I think that's what, you know, makes him successful. He's a seasoned vet, and there's nothing you can throw at him that can confuse him.
How do you guys rise to that challenge then?
Knowing our assignments, Montreal has a very very unique defense. They move a lot of guys around. They try to confuse you and cause a lot of chaos. And you just have to be on your P's and Q's on every play, or they're going to have success.